First question is, what will be the output? A is 300, B, C. A is greater than or equal to 400. So 300 greater than or equal to 400, this is false. This is false. So what will happen? This line is not going to execute. Only this line will execute. So C will be 200. But what about B? B, this line was never executed and B was never initialized. So there will be some garbage value in B, but C will show 200. Next is A is equal to 500. A is greater than or equal to 400. So 500 is actually equal to this greater than or equal to 400. So this line will be executed. What will you will get? You will get B as 300 and C eventually this line will also execute. C will be 200. Then x equal to 10, y equal to 20, then x is equal to y. This is a semicolon. If x is equal to y, you don't want to do anything. So this line has no value. X will be 10, y will be 20. 10 and 20 will be printed. X equal to 3, y equal to 5, x double is equal to 3. Means you are checking whether x is equal to 3 or not. Yes, it is indeed x equal to 3. So you'll print x, that is 3. And this 3 will be printed. Else, because there is a semicolon after this, so you don't want to print anything. You don't want to print anything. So this will also be printed. Y equal to 5. So 5 will also be printed. Because else, if this semicolon wouldn't have been there, this 3 will be the only output. X equal to 3 and y equal to 3.0. X double is equal to y. What will be the answer? See, 3 and 3.0 are different. But when you compare them, this 3 and 3.0 cannot be compared. So this has to be upgraded. So this will be 3.0, 3.0, and now they both are equal. X and Y are equal will be shown. They are equal. X equal to 3, Y, Z. Now you are assigning Y and X as 10. So Y is 10 and X is also 10. Now you are saying X is less than 10, which is assigned to Z. So what will be printed? You are trying to print x, y and z. So what will happen here? Y will be printed as what it is. Now x you have assigned as 3. Now 3 is less than 10. So what this z will be? Z will be 0 because 3 is this n. When you assign 10, this x will become 10 and 10 will be not less than 10. So that will be 0. I hope you got the idea. Y and z. Y and Z, Y, this X and Y will have no problem. They are 10 only. But when you assign Z equal to X less than 10, so 10 is not less than 10. You get a 0 here. K equal to 35. This is a quite a tricky question. This X is equal to 35 and you want to print X, K double is equal to 35. So 35 double is equal to 35. Is it true or false? It is indeed true. But when you print it, you will get a 0 here. You can run this program. You can see it. Then k equal to 50. So 50 will be printed here. K is greater than 40. That is 35 is greater than 40. This is not true. So you will get a 0 here. Though it is true here, k double is equal to 35. If you see, k double is equal to 35. I think this, you must be tempted because I was also saying this and I said that 35 is equal to 35 and you will get at 1 here. But eventually when I ran this program, an actual scenario means IDE, this actually gave me 0. Point out the errors if any in the following programs. So A is 12.25, B is 12.52. If A is equal to B means not, this is assignment operator, A and B are equal. So this is, you are just assigning, you are not comparing anything. So you should use double is equal to here. Next is J equal to 10, K is equal to 12. If K is less than, greater than equal to J, K is J, J equal to K, there is no problem. The braces are also true, means they are indented, formatted. So no error. Then we have capital X less than small x. Capital X and small x, but this capital X has ASCII value which is less than small x. This is true. This will be the ASCII values. So the answer will be clear, there is no error. These are internally character are treated as integers only. Then you have x equal to 10, x greater than equal to 2, then is not allowed. There is nothing called then in this C. So then cannot be used in C. X is equal to 10 if x greater than equal to 2. Where is the bracket? Where is the round bracket? This is the problem. There is error. Parenthesis you have to take. Then x equal to 10, y equal to 15, x modulo 2 is equal to y modulo 3. So there is just one apprehension. You can use this one double, because this is going to give you a number, this is going to give you a number. So a number assigned to number, this is not which what logic means. You need to use the double is equal to, not assignment. Attempt the following question. If cost price and selling price of an item is input through the keyboard, write a program to determine whether the seller has made profit or incurred loss. Also, determine how much profit he made or incurred loss. So the profit is actually what amount he sold and what amount he purchased. This is profit. And what is loss? What amount he purchased and how much he sold. This is the loss. So we'll write a program, calculate profit or loss, stdio.h, conio.h. We'll take cost price, selling price, profit and loss. We'll enter the cost price and selling price. We'll enter, take them in CP and SP. As I just suggested, the profit is selling price minus cost price. You can write in a comment also, selling price minus cost price is your profit. Now loss, as I just said, it will be cost price minus selling price, because the cost price is higher, then only you have incurred a loss. Now let us check this P&L. If P is greater than 0, you have made a profit. If less, L is greater than 0, the seller is in loss. If P is equal to 0, then there is no loss, there is no profit. And you can come out using get switch. Any integer is input through the keyboard. Write a program to find out whether it is an odd number or even number. Any number, say you have 7. Take modulo 2. You will get 1 here. What I am trying to say here is, you divide 7 with 2. 2 threes are 6, you get a remainder 1. When you divide an even number, say 6 modulo 2, divide 2. 2 threes are 6, you get 0. So whenever you take modulo with 2 and you get 0, then it is an even number. This is what you have to use here. So we'll write a program, we'll write a comment, check whether a number is even or odd, stdio.h. Conio.h will include, and we say we'll take a number n and enter any number. This will take in n. Then we say n modulo 2. What the logic I this explained here, n modulo 2 equal to 0. If you take a modulo with 2 and it actually equate to 0, then you say the number is even, otherwise the number is odd, and you can come out. Any year is input through the keyboard, write a program to determine whether the year is a leap year or not. We'll use a modulo. What is a leap year? The year is a leap if it is fully divisible by 100 and 400. Okay. Or it has to be, it has to be divided simultaneously by 100 and 400. This is a condition. And means 100 and 400 if it is fully divisible. Otherwise, it is a leap if it is fully divisible by 4. So it has to be fully divisible by 100 and 400, or it is divisible by 4. This you have to use. So stdio.h and conio.h will use. Then we'll take a yr year, this a yr for year, and we'll clear screen, and then we'll enter the year. This year will take in yr. This year will take in yr. So what first condition says? That it has to be divisible, or the modulo of 100 has to be 0 if it is a leap year. So first we check for 100. If yr year is modulo 100 is 0, then we check for 400. If it is okay, then we go inside. If yr year modulo 400 is 0, this is the second condition. Then if both are true, then we say leap year, otherwise we say not a leap year. Now we have to check for 4 also. We take the year modulo 4. If it is completely or fully divisible, we will say leap year, otherwise we say not a leap year, and we come out. According to Gregorian calendar, it was Monday on the date this 1/1/1900. If any year is input through the keyboard, write a program to find out what is the day on the 1st January of this year. We'll use a modulo here. We'll use a modulo 7. How? See, in order to calculate the day, we want to calculate the day on the 1st January of any year. So first of all, we'll take stdio.h, conio.h, we'll take this. Then we'll have leap days, first day and yr. See, the normal days and total days can be large, so we will take it in long int. We'll try to enter the year in yr. This is long doubles, that is why we have this long integer has to be taken as ld. This is the format of long integer, ld. So the normal days will be yr minus 1 into 365, year minus 1. This is how it goes. How old are you? You are 19 years old or 20 years old. Say you are 20 years old. But how you know 20 years old? When you have completed your 19 years, you are 20 years old. 19.1 is also 20. That is why we have taken this logic, yr minus 1 into 365. For leap years, we have to take yr minus 1 by 4 minus, see this is minus, yr minus 1 by 100 plus yr minus year minus 1 by 400. This is the leap days. How many leap days? You have to take this, subtracted by this, and you have to add this. So now total days will be normal days plus leap days. This is okay, total days. Now we'll take a modulo with 7. We'll take modulo with 7. When we take modulo with 7, we can get, because this is 7, we can get 7 possibilities. Either 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it is 0 Monday, 1 Tuesday, 2 the first day, that is first day. 2 Wednesday, 3 means Thursday, 4 means Friday, 5 means Saturday, 6 means Sunday. This is how you compute this. A 5-digit number is entered through the keyboard. Write a program to obtain the reverse number and determine whether the original number is equal to the reverse number. They are equal or not. So how to get this? First of all, we need to check whether the number and its reversed number are equal. Take stdio.h, conio.h. We have n, a, b, num. Because the reverse number can be large, we don't know about that. So we take long int here as reverse number equal to 0. And we need to initialize this also. Otherwise, we'll get some garbage value. We have to declare this as long as I just suggested, because if after reversing it can be very large number. It can be a large number. So first we'll enter the 5-digit number. As I just said, that we can fix a limit. There is no hard and fast rule here, but you can fix the limit. So when we enter a number, say I have a number, say 3, 2, 1, 4, 5. If I'll take a modulo, I will take a division. I will take a modulo, I will take a division, and you just see what happens here. I'll give you just one example, you'll understand all these. If I take 10 here and divide 3 to 1, 4, 5, this will be 3, we'll get 2, 10 to the 20, you get 1, 4, 10, 1's are 10, you get 4. Then 5, 10 4s are 40, you get 5. This number is this result, and this modulo, which is the divisor, which is the remainder, is this. So when you want to find a remainder, means this last number actually. You want to find out this last number, you have to take the modulo with 10. If you want this number, you have to eliminate this last number, you have to take the previous numbers. You have to take the division. This is what is being done. And when we reverse 5-digit number, when we take 5, it has to be multiplied by 10000. Then when you take 4 out, you have to multiply it by 1000. When you take this 1 out, you have to multiply it by 100. When you take this 2 out, you have to multiply it by 10. When you take this 3, you just add 3 like this. So now this number will be reversed. So what we will do, first take the number, which is this number, we'll divide it and we'll modulo it. So in modulo we get 5 here, in division we get 3, 2, 1, 4. So what we will do, 5 into this plus 0. Initially it is 0. Now we are left with 3 to 1 4. Now take the modulo of 10, 3 to 1 4. You get 4 here, you get rest number here, 3 to 1. Again you multiply 4 with 1000, add it to the previous number. Means 4 into 1000 plus 5 into this. This was already done, this you will add here. Next is, you take this 3 to 1 and take the modulo, you get 1. And you get 1 here, you get 32 here. Again you have to take this 1 and multiply it by 100 and add it to the previous result. Now what you have got here, 32. 32. Now again do the same stuff. You get 2 here, you get 3 here. Now multiply this 2 with 10 and add it to the previous result. And you take the modulo of 3 and 3 by 10, you get 3 only. So now you add final 3. So you have reverse number and this we have already stored here. See, the first number we already stored here. So that we can, this number. Because we want to check it. See, this number has to be checked. So this number was entered and this we can easily check. So we have entered this, entered number is stored for comparison later. So now we'll compare. When we compare, if they are two, we say they are equal, otherwise they are not equal, and we come out. Logical operators. If say x equal to 1, y equal to 6, z equal to 1, find the values of the expression in the following table. So x is greater than 9 and y is not equal to 3, what you get? You get 1. How? X, that is 11, is greater than 9 and y, that is 6, not equal to 3. So 11 is greater than 9, this is true, you get 1. And 6 is not equal to 3 and this is also true. So in AND, when both are true, you get true, so you get 1. I'll take one more example, say this one. NOT, x greater than 14. So NOT x greater than 14, x is 11. 11 is greater than 14. 11 is greater than 14, no. So this will give you 0. NOT 0, this NOT 0 means 1, so you get a 1. I hope you'll be able to do the others. What is the output of the following? I is 4, z is 12. This is assignment. I is assignment and you have said z is greater than 50. So what you get? You'll get Dean of Student Affairs, because this is an assignment and z is greater than 50. Z is greater than this 50, 12 is greater than 50. This is false. But this is true, because even if you assign, this is a positive, this is a number which is not zero. So anything which has non-zero in OR, you'll get a true. So you get a Dean of Student Affairs. Then I equal to 4, z equal to 12. I is 5, again assignment. You got a positive number here. And this z is greater than 5. 12 is greater than 5. So what you get? This is true. This is also true. You get this. In AND, both sides has to be true to get the true result. This will not be, this not, this line will not be executed. So you get, let us see. Then this is 4, j equal to minus 1, k equal to 0. Let us take this one. I, j, k. So 4 or j means minus 1 or k, 0. In OR, if any of these is not 0, you get 1. So here you get 1. In this you get 1. Because 4 and minus 1 is treated as true. This is treated as false. Now let us come here. Why? I, j and k means 4 or j means minus 1. And k means 0. 4 means I, j is minus 1 and k is 0. So what you get? You are getting a 0 here. How? First of all, we have to see that getting a 0 is only possible, because here see, if you do this, 4 or minus 1, because these both are non-zero, so you get a 1 here, and 1 and 0, 1 and 0 you'll get as 0. So this is your 0. I hope you got the idea. In this case, I and j or k. I is what? 4 and j is what? Minus 1 or k. K is 0. K is 0. So what you get here in z? First of all, we have done this, I guess, 4 and no, we have not. We have done this already. So let us see the z we are taking. 4 and j is minus 1 and then we have k as 0. Now here minus 1 and 0 will give you what? This will give you my positive value, means say 1, and 4 and 1 will give you 1. So you get 1. Now here what is y? This is I plus 1 and j plus 1 and k plus 2. So first we will always plus and minus, they have higher precedence than the AND and OR operator. So we'll put the value here, 4 plus 5 and j plus 1, minus 1 plus 1, then OR k plus 2, 0 plus 2. What is this? 4 plus 5, 9. What is this? Minus 1 plus 1, 0. And what is this? 0 plus 2 is 2. Now you get a result 1 here. How? 0 or 2, first OR will be done. So 0 or 2 will give you 1, and 9 and 1 will give you 1, because anything which is other than 0 will always be taken as 1. So 9 is taken as 1, 9 is taken as 1, and 1 and 1 is 1. How about this one? See, I is 4 plus 5 or j means minus 1 plus 1 and k means 0 plus 2. 4 plus 5, 9, or the 0 and 2. Again, we have 0 and 2. What do you get here? You get a 0. But this is OR. 9 and 0 is 1. So you get a 1. This is minus 3 and 3. So let us write here what will come here. Not I minus 3. Then we have plus, this is not j, so not j, 3 into 1. First this unary will be done, so not minus 3, anything other than, we have already seen anything which is not 0 is taken as positive. So not minus 3 will be your, because this is positive, it will give you 0. Again this will give you 0 and this is into 1. So 0 into 1 is 0, 0 plus 0 is 0, so you get if 0, and this will take you to this line. This line will not be executed. You get binary wo. Point out the errors, if any, in the following programs. The program is an example of using logical errors. So I equal to 2 and j is equal to 2. Is there any error? No error. It is absolutely fine. Code flag. Code equal to 1 and flag equal to 0. So there is only one ampersand. You have to have double ampersand. This is the error. Here. A, spy is A, password is Z. So spy equal to A or password. OR is not allowed. You have to write a pipe. You have to use a pipe. So this is the error. I equal to 10, J equal to 20. If I equal to 5 and if I J equal to 10, no. This is not done. We have to use, you just have to take out this if. No other if is employed. You have to take if I equal to 5, take off this, take this off, and just this is okay. I equal to 5 and J equal to 10. This is what is to be done.